Hi traders, the Fibonacci sequence has a solid mathematical foundation and is widely present in various fields such as nature, art, and science. From natural geometry to the golden ratio and biological structures, Fibonacci's influence is everywhere. Even our galaxy follows a spiral pattern known as the logarithmic spiral, closely related to the Fibonacci spiral, where the distances between points adhere to the golden ratio, approximately 1.618. In trading, Fibonacci method, especially Fibonacci retracement levels, are seen as a self-fulfilling prophecy. Because the Fibonacci retracement theory has a solid mathematical foundation and is widely popular and trusted by many traders, it has the potential to significantly impact the market. After thorough research and development, we've crafted a system called Zephyrus Force that leverages Fibonacci retracement to find precise trading signals. But this system is not just about Fibonacci levels. It offers a comprehensive approach to trading. Join me as we dive deeper into how Zephyrus Force can enhance your trading strategy. What sets Zephyrus Force apart is its unique interface, unlike any of our previous systems. Using advanced algorithms, it provides two parallel cloud bands that create boundaries for price movement. Cloud bands take on many different roles. Not only that, the system also provides two types of trading signals: Fib signals and PE signals. In addition, Zephyrus Force works seamlessly across all different bar types, so you can trust its versatility. But there's an exciting feature that's completely different from anything we've done before, which I'll reveal at the end of this video. When it comes to trend identification, Zephyrus Force offers high reliability. You can recognize different stages of a trend through the shape of the two cloud bands. Initially, when a trend begins, the middle line and the clouds will change color: blue for an uptrend and pink for a downtrend. When the clouds are flat, it signals that the market is moving sideways or losing momentum. Finally, the steeper the cloud angles, the stronger the price movement, which helps reinforce your buy and sell signals. Here you can see the price moving sideways and losing upward momentum, indicated by the two flat cloud bands. Then, the trend reversed. In the parameters, we provide you with the ability to flexibly confirm trends using two settings: fast period and slow period. It is the short-term period and the long-term period respectively for the algorithm to provide trend signals. Let's look at the following example. By adjusting these parameters in the settings, you can reduce noise and better identify trends across different market conditions. Note that the smaller these two parameters, the more sensitive the trend signal will be to price changes. Conversely, larger values make the trend signal slower to react, resulting in delayed trend signals. Next, let's move on to the mechanism of forming zones and signals in the system. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, one of the two signals provided by the system is the Fibonacci signal. Typically, identifying Fibonacci signals involves pinpointing highs and lows to find Fibonacci retracement levels. However, this can be challenging. Therefore, we've simplified this by using swing points. Let me illustrate how the Fibonacci signals are identified. In an uptrend, the system only identifies and draws Fibonacci retracement zones from swing lows to swing highs. You decide the signal identification zone, choosing the range from min retracement to max retracement. These are the minimum and maximum retracement levels you set for the system to find signals. For example, here I've set the levels to 0.382, 38.2%, to 0.6188, 61.8%. So the system will only look for trading signals within this range. Conversely, in a downtrend, the system identifies and draws Fibonacci retracement zones from swing highs to swing lows. Similarly, the signal zone is formed from min retracement to max retracement, as specified by you. Note that the Fibonacci retracement zone is only formed when it meets two conditions you set in the parameters: Fibonacci, offset, ticks, and Fibonacci, min distance, bars. These parameters define the minimum distance between swing highs and swing lows in ticks and bars. For example, if the distance between two swing points is 90 ticks and 18 bars, and you've set the parameters to 5, the Fibonacci zone will be displayed on the chart. Next, let's explore the system's price action signals. These are also pullback signals, but they form in a completely different way, based on the two cloud bands. The cloud bands act as support and resistance, closely following the price and creating movement boundaries. In a downtrend, signals are only identified when the price enters the upper cloud band. Conversely, in an uptrend, signals are identified when the price enters the lower cloud band. You can adjust the width of these cloud bands to increase or decrease the number of trading signals according to your preference. Setting the band. Period parameter smaller will make the cloud bands follow the price more closely, resulting in more proposed price action signals. Increasing the band. Period parameter will reduce the number of signals and create more distance between the clouds and the price, reducing noise. Additionally, adjusting the band. Period parameter affects the trailing stop plot suggestions. That's right, we just mentioned the trailing stop. This is also an interesting feature with a completely different mechanism compared to previous systems. Now let's delve into support resistance levels and the trailing stop plot to understand their relationship with the cloud bands and their unique features. First, support and resistance levels. Pink levels represent resistance and green levels represent support. These levels are formed when the cloud bands are flat. When the two cloud bands flatten, it indicates that the market has encountered resistance, reducing buying or selling momentum and creating short-term or long-term swing points. These points form support and resistance levels, aiding traders in analyzing price action when the price revisits these levels or in setting stop and target orders. Next, the trailing stop plot. This new trailing stop mechanism is based on price action rather than ATR or any other mathematical formula. In a downtrend, when the price breaks out of the flat phase of the lower cloud band or support levels, the trailing stop forms and closely follows the price until it is crossed by the price. In an uptrend, the trailing stop appears when the price breaks out of the flat phase of the upper cloud band or resistance levels and continues until the price crosses it. So why did we develop the trailing stop based on price action, and how effective is it? The purpose of developing the trailing stop based on price action is to protect the profits you've earned. When the price breaks through the flat phases of the cloud bands, it also breaks through support and resistance levels. This often signals a strong momentum in price movement. However, when prices move with such strong momentum, the market is prone to becoming overbought or oversold, increasing the likelihood of a correction. Therefore, our new trailing stop mechanism helps protect your profits by responding to these sudden changes and shifts in price momentum. Let's dive into some trade simulations with Zephyrus Force. First up, I'll execute a sell order using a price action signal. The cloud bands act as resistance and support, so we'll place our stop above the upper band and adjust it as the trailing stop kicks in. Here, after the system suggests the trailing stop using dots to indicate where to move the stop, we will adjust the stop according to this plot. After that, the price adjusted and crossed the trailing stop plot, allowing you to better protect your profits. Next, let's go for a buy order. I'll set the target based on the resistance levels, and the stop will be below the lower band. We'll enter this trade with three contracts and take profits at the resistance levels. Remember, when the cloud bands are flat, it signals that the trend is weakening. So be sure to move the stop closer to the flat cloud area to protect your profits. We have achieved three targets. Finally, let's move on to the last part. Let's take a look at some real signals on NQ with the King Renko chart and ES with the 5-minute chart. we've walked you through the entire mechanism of the Zephyrus Force system. Get ready to elevate your trading experience with Zephyrus Force. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, and hit the notification bell so you never miss an update from ninZa.co. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more exciting products coming your way. See you next time.